Hey guys, Brad M73 here. Welcome back to Pure Farming 2018. We're going to get moving along here where we have to drive to the store and buy a water trailer and a sprayer. Oh, the sprayer, I think, is for the trees, if I'm not mistaken. We're just going to do it. Gonna do it. And we're getting music in the game, which I should probably turn down. Let me see if I remember how to do this. Sound control to Major Tom. Music volume. Let's turn this down to like 15% or something. Oh wait, that might be the music or the radio volume. Let's turn the radio volume down too. Because I don't want to get, like, the heck? Apparently that's not going to work. Whoops. Got to apply, don't we? Yeah, it's like all the music, you know, all the sound went down. I totally, oh my gosh. What is going on? Oh my gosh. Master volume, what? Audio, yep, enabled. So apparently I just have to turn down music volume. Okay. Doesn't help me at all. That's kind of freaking stupid. I'm gonna have to put that on the patch notes for hopefully the next patch. Or not, I don't have to put it on the patch notes. I'm gonna have to make sure that they patch it during the next patch. I love how they have like a gazillion audio options and they... Oh. I'm just going to chalk it up to it being early in the game's release. Okay. Okay, so it must be like an in-game radio, or in-cab radio. See, playing music. Can I just turn this off? Radio on off. Oh, there we go. Yay! Buy a machine. So I have to get the Sipma WA, or Sipma WA600 Delphine tank trailer water. Simpa Delphine. Okay, I think it's this one, right? Meow. Yep. And then the Akpil Chwast XL Sad. It's a sad sprayer. Aw, cheer up, little buddy. I'm gonna say this might be an other. Yeah, right here. Man, that's expensive. All right. So, find the farmer. Let's go ahead and hook up the trailer, I guess. The water trailer. Oh, don't want to drive through one of the stores. All right. Oh. Since I just found one, I would like to point out these green emeralds, or no, I'm sorry, sapphires. And we have to collect 100 of them to get, I think the reward is like $200,000. It's not like $1 million, like in Farming Simulator. But it's, you know, it's kind of like collecting the gold coins and gold nuggets in Farming Simulator games. And they are scattered about the map. Okay. Side tasks. So attach the dolphin tank, fill the tank trailer, fill the orchards tank, connect the sprayer, fill the sprayer with pesticide, go to the edge of the orchard and spray the orchard. Okay. That was weird. Alright, so where... Whoops. No, where is the closest water filling point? There's one down there, but then there's also one... Oh no, there's one up here, but we can't get to that one yet. Because the map is locked. Another thing they changed was having the time revert to essentially real time, apparently. So like 1x is actually 1 full minute in the game, is 1 full, you know, minute real life. And of course you can increase or decrease that as you choose. So if you want to accelerate time a little bit, which you'll obviously have to... oh, there's another sapphire. I see another one straight ahead there, up by the rocks. I'm not going to worry about those right now because, you know, all of the parts of the map are occluded, so we won't be able to get all 100 anyway. But, you know, if you're in the free farming mode, you could definitely do that. If you so wanted. I have a bottle of water, and the bottom is kind of like tipped over, or not tipped over, but it's like bashed in a little bit, and so I'm worried about it tipping over. All right, there is that done. And now we're really slow. We've got a big heavy trailer. Kind of a dinky little tractor here. I will point out that the sapphires are fairly easy to find at night because they glow. And, you know, they actually put out light. So, it's generally fairly easy to find them if you're, you know, if you want to look for them. I don't know if I'm going to do an episode where I find them all. I'd have to do, like, a few run-throughs because some of them are kind of tricky to find. And the map is quite large, so, you know, in between finding each one, it's kind of a... bit of a challenge. I actually, just in my normal search, I was searching for them. I think I spent about 3 hours looking for them all. But I, you know, it's like I don't have a guaranteed place for them or anything, you know, to go and find them. All right, so there's that. Let's disconnect that. Now we've got to go up and get the sprayer. So that we can complete this job. I think we'll earn like, I don't know, $5,000 or $10,000 or something for this. So we will have to see. So I also wanted to apologize to everybody for not doing any videos over the weekend. I know I kind of did just the first video and then kind of left you guys hanging. I actually had kind of a family emergency and had to have my mother come stay with me for the weekend because she had like a water backup problem and she couldn't use the water in her home. So she came over to stay with me for the weekend, which was nice, I guess. All right, edge of the orchard. And so, yeah, I didn't really get to do any recording, but you know, I did have some spare time where I was able to play some Star Citizen again. So I'm really considering making some or a few Star Citizen videos just to kind of show like where the game is. I did a video a long time ago, but yeah, nothing recently. Gosh, that must have been back in like 2015. If you want to see it, you can go back and look at my Star Citizen video. I think I only did one. I might have done two, but I think I only did the one. This is kind of cool. What is this, like a big fan to like blow out all the spray everywhere? Actually, you know what? I think my cousins have one of these types of sprayers. It's not an act pill, but it's, you know, similar in design with the big fan on the back. Because I know that they've got a trailer, like a spray trailer, on their orchard that is very similar to this. And that's how they spray the apple trees. And people, you know, I know that there's like this kind of push for organic food and things like that in some areas. People always ask, like, oh, you know, are your apples organic? And apparently, they're about, if you want to have a successful orchard, you have to spray your trees. Otherwise, the insects get them. Because actually, they tried, I think the first several years of their orchard, they actually kind of tried to go with like minimal spraying. And the insects just get onto the apples and they essentially poke holes in the apples. And they end up getting like these little kind of dried up dimples all over your apples. And you can still eat the apples just fine, but they don't look as nice. And so, you know, if you're wanting to sell apples to a local grocer or something like that, it then becomes a challenge because, you know, they don't look very nice, so they're not going to sell as well. And so they've started spraying more, and the problem is, you know, actually decreased, which is good for them. And now they're selling apples like crazy. Well, not right now, because it's not apple season, but you know what I'm saying. Or maybe you don't know what I'm saying. All right, so what I'm going to do is, hello. We're going to detach the rear device here. I'm going to go down and get this water tank. I'm going to come back and fill that up. Kind of just leave it near the farm somewhere. I'm sure you're going to have to water something in the near future. Wait, what do we have to do now? Proceed to the... Oh. Go to the... Oh, great. Now we have to plow. Well, let's go ahead... Yeah, let's run down here. It's going to take a while to plow the field. And trust me, plowing is not that exciting to watch. And I'll probably switch over to mouse and keyboard because I think it's a little bit easier to manually plow with the keyboard controls. I wish you could use the two interchangeably, but Techlens is saying that... or Ice Flames, which is the developer. They're basically saying that they can't, like, you can't have the controller and keyboard profiles active at the same time. And yet every other farming simulator game, you know, allows for that. So I don't know what they're talking about. They probably wrote the code a certain way, and it's going to now be a giant pain to switch back to doing it, or not to switch back, but to switch to doing it that way in the first place. So I don't know. Where do we have to go? Oh, we have to go over there. So I'm just going to leave this water tank over here because I think we have to purchase. No. Stop working. There we go. Now we'll detach. Why do we have to plow this field and not the smaller field? Let's try to get some more light as well. Let's increase the passage of time. So now we're up to 24 times. Actually, that's a little bit faster. Let's go to 12 times and see how this works. This might be approximately what the game was set to previously before the 1.1.1 patch. I am running 1.1.1. I believe that there's going to be another patch either late this week or the next week. I can't remember if they said it was going to be the end of this week or in 2 weeks. It might have been 2 weeks. Proceed to the indicated location. Okay. Go to the edge of the field, thank you. And let's see here. I want to rotate it over this way. Unfold. And then just come down here to the field edge and lower. So now I'm going to switch over to keyboard. And I don't know how to... Let's see. Cruise control, left shift. Ah, why is it so... Man, it's really jerky. It's not like this when I'm not recording, so this it must be something with OBS or... Or just recording in general. Let's see here. So let's move. I'm going to switch back to the controller here. Hold. Rotate. Unfold. Man, it's like really jerky now. I'm going to have to ask my contact about that and see if they can look into it. I mean, typically there's some, you know, CPU bottleneck, but there's none on mine. Absolutely not. I was doing some test recording, and I think the game only uses like 15 or 20% of my CPU. And remember, I'm using an i7-5960X, so that's an 8-core CPU. And the recording software I know, you know, doesn't dig into it that much either, so yeah. And I've heard some other YouTubers complain about the fact that the game is kind of jittery as well, so it's not just me. All right. So basically, folding the plow, you get the best. You know, like the widest swath. You could kind of go off the wheel here, and I could kind of show you what I mean. If you look at the tire here on the right of the plow, there's like a small wheel you can see rotating just to the left of that, and that's kind of like where your marker would be. So if we come over here, and we put the plow down here. you know, we should get about the same width without having to rotate the plow every time. Now, eventually, you're going to be able to hire workers. The patch did re-enable that, but because it's so early in the campaign or in the story mode, you cannot hire workers. So you have to go through at least one manual plowing and one, I think, manual cultivating. So you have to do one, you know, plow once, cultivate once, and then you'll be good to go. But it's going to take us a while just to get this done. So I tell you guys what I'm going to do. I'm actually going to fast forward this. We're going to just do a quick time lapse, and then we will see you back in just a moment, and we'll continue on. Okay, so we've got all this plowed. Now we have to attach the seeder, it looks like. Which is weird, because I don't know why it's not asking us to attach the cultivator. Let's just put this plow back. Let's see. No. Do, 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 do. Cedar, cedar, cedar. And buy wheat. And sow the field. Huh, okay. So in order to fill up the cedar, basically you just kind of pull up until it says wheat down at the corner. So wait for it to fill up. And apparently we have to sow the field and irrigate the field. One thing I would like to do first, though, is to actually cultivate the field, because that's going to give us a little bit better yield. So let's go do that. Let's go see if we can actually cultivate the field first. The plowing took about 20 minutes from start to finish, maybe slightly more. Wait, where's our? We don't have a. No way. I guess we don't have a cultivator. I'm kind of surprised. I thought we had one somewhere. Well, maybe we buy one later. I don't know. Let's go back. We're going to get set up for doing the seeding. But we're going to do the seeding in the next episode. So it looks like we've got to, we'll do the sowing slash seeding, whatever you want to call it. We'll be doing the irrigation. I'll show you how to do that. And we'll continue on our journey in Pure Farming 2018. Guys, I hope you like your liking the series. Please hit that like button if you're having fun hanging out with me. Don't forget to leave a comment. Let me know how I'm doing, what you think of the game, and if you haven't done so, please subscribe for this and many more videos. Guys, I'm BradM73. This has been Pure Farming 2018. I'll see you next time. Bye for now.